Number one states that we have 6.50 grams of aluminum reacting with an excess of oxygen, and we're trying to figure out how many grams of aluminum oxide can be formed through this reaction. We know aluminum is Al and oxygen is O2 because it's diatomic, and aluminum oxide, after balancing the charges of Al and oxygen, we end up with Al2O3. Next step of the problem, we have Al reacting, so it's plus O2, which is yielding Al2O3. We go back to the basics of balancing. So we have 4Al plus 3O2 yielding 2Al2O3. We know that Al is the LR because the problem states we have an excess of oxygen. So you fast forward to knowing that Al is the limiting reagent, and we set up either the box or by hand, whichever way you prefer. We know that in the vessel before the reaction, we're given that we have 6.50 grams of aluminum. We know that there's an excess of O2, so we're just calculating the aluminum, and we're trying to convert that grams to moles. We take 6.50 grams and we divide it by the molar mass of aluminum, which is over there, which is 26.98, and we end up with 0.24 moles of aluminum. We then set up the LR calculations. We have 0.24 moles of aluminum times 2Al2O3 over 4Al. As we know from the balanced equation, we do this dimensional analysis, so we cross out the Al, and we end up with 0.12 moles of Al2O3 after completing this problem. But the answer is not 0.12 moles of Al2O3 because it's asking for that number in grams. So to convert back to grams, we take 0.12 moles of Al2O3, multiply that by 102 grams of Al2O3, which is the molar mass, by 16 times 3 plus 26.98 times 2, which is the mass per moles per gram of Al. And we end up with 102 grams per mole after adding those two calculations. We then get an answer of 12.2 grams of Al2O3, and that's how we came conclusion.
Okay, problem two states that if 6.0 grams of aluminum react with excess bromide to produce 50.3 grams of aluminum bromide, what is the theoretical yield of this reaction? So usually we have to always find that if the the equation has to be balanced. In this case, the reaction that they give us, the equation's balanced. Right off the bat, we could tell that aluminum is the limiting reagent because we have excess bromide. So knowing that, we have to convert the weight of aluminum, 6.0 grams, into its molecular weight of 26.98 grams per mole, and we get a result of 0.22 moles. From looking at this reaction, that we find that 2 moles of aluminum produced to create 2 moles of aluminum bromide. So right off the bat, we can also see that the ratio is 2 to 2, or 1 to 1. So that knowing this, we now know that 0.22 moles times the molecular weight of aluminum bromide will give us the theoretical yield in grams. So the molecular weight of aluminum bromide is 26.98 plus 79.90 times 3, and it gives us a result of 266.68 grams per mole of aluminum bromide. That multiplied by 0.22 moles will give us 58.66 grams, or rounded up to the next significant figure, 58.7 grams.
Problem 3 states, consider the reaction 4Al plus 3MnO2 goes to 3NN plus 2Al2O3. At 22 grams of Al, react with 13 grams of manganese oxide. How much excess reactant remains after the reaction is run to completion? Step 1, start with the balanced chemical equation. Check it, and we have that, we can move on. Step 2, convert the grams of the reactant to the moles of the reactant. Take the grams of aluminum, divide it by the molecular weight, moles of aluminum. Take grams of MnO2, divide by molecular weight of MnO2, moles of MnO2. How to get the molecular weight of MnO2 is here if you need it. Now that you have moles and moles, you can compare them to determine the limiting reagent. If you compare the number of moles of aluminum that you have and see how much Al2O3 in theory that would produce, you get 0.4077 moles. If you take the amount of moles of MnO2 you have and see how much, in theory, Al2O3 that would produce, you get 0.0977. That's smaller, so MnO2 is the limiting reagent. Step 4, calculate how much reaction is actually used. MnO2 is the limiting reagent, all of that is going to be used. For Al, use the number of moles of MnO2 that actually react, use the mole ratios, and determine how much Al actually therefore reacts in terms of moles. Now that you know how many moles of Al actually reacts, convert that to grams and how much excess reagent is left over. Subtract the amount you're given, which is 22 grams of aluminum, from the amount actually consumed, which is 5.37 grams of aluminum. Subtract those from each other, and you get 16.62 grams of aluminum that was actually used, about 17.